the magnificent Western United States. It's been home to the American cowboy and cowgirl for more than 200 years. Hi, my name's Randy Caruso, and I'm here today to tell you about a brand new television program called Cowgirl Divas. It's a program that celebrates the great Western tradition with a modern twist. So check it out.
My name is Siarra Ritter, and I love the rodeo life. I do think that a cowgirl is the ultimate modern woman because it's all about morals and ethics and, you know, the kind of person that you are. And I think that kind of personality gets you a lot further in life. And I do think cowgirls, you know, we're strong, strong-hearted. When we love something, we love it with all of our hearts. Like, there's no half-hearted thing. Like, we have very strong hearts. Cowgirls are definitely stubborn. You know, we're very strong-minded. We know what we want. We know how we want it. And convincing a cowgirl otherwise, good luck with that. Because most of the time, you're not gonna change a cowgirl's mind. So I have to say, definitely a cowgirl is like the modern woman. Just getting on the horse is, you know, you might die today kind of thing. Like, you could just fall off and just happen to slide off and hit the ground and hit your head just right and boom, you're dead. It's just that free feeling, like you feel like a bird that could just fly away at any moment, and it's just an amazing feeling. It's got the adrenaline in there too. That might be why your mind goes blank, because you got so much adrenaline going through you. But it's definitely an adrenaline rush. And you just feel 100% free. My life motto is cowgirl up. And I have to say, it really rounds about just about everything. You know, it doesn't have to just be with the rodeo. It could be school, it could be work, it could be family drama, anything. You know, you just suck it up and get back on.
As you can see, Siarra Ritter and the other cowgirls take this very seriously. They train hard, and they make sure that they can put their best foot forward when they step into that rodeo arena.
You're doing a lot better. From the first couple rides, it was a little bit more wild, and now you're getting more finessed and control of your horse.
She definitely seems like she's trying more. At first she was just like, F all you guys, I ain't doing it.
I really like the training side of it. You know, the speed of course is always going to be fun, but I like the training side, the more technical side of everything.
If she goes to lean, you also can make her drive with her hindquarters more and pick herself up. So if she would round her body around the barrel instead, then it'd pick it all up instead of diving into it.
I've been practically training my whole life to do what my dream is. It's not easy. You don't think riding's easy. It's a workout. You know, you have to be in shape. Your horse has to be in shape.
I've noticed the faster she goes, the closer and closer she gets to the barrel, just because she's so tall and long-legged. I've seen so many barrel horses that are tall that when they lean, when they're going so fast, they knock over the barrels. So I thought, like, if I taught her to go wider when she did lean, she wouldn't hit the barrels.
You, most certainly you could do really well at the Three Rivers Barrel Race. Just want to make sure you can tighten up your turns for the first, second, and the third. Actually, your home is a really good barrel, your third barrel. We just need to work on mostly the lead changes in between the first and the second.
The feeling that riding gives me is not only adrenaline, but it's a passion. At the end of the day, you feel completed. You know, let's say you go out there and you have a horse that's just fighting you and you're not doing it and you're losing, but at the end of the day, they do that one fantastic run for you. It's just a great feeling of accomplishment.
Great American traditions in the beautiful Western United States, including the rodeo. Well, we went to Springville, California and caught up with fans as they participated in all the fun.
Brushed him out, made him look pretty again, and then just put the saddle pads on, saddled them up. We got our bridles and breast collars all ready to go, and then our drill master does our polar wraps for us because she does them really, really pretty. And then after that, we have our glitter crew that comes around and they take hair gel and a paintbrush and they paint this right here, and then they sprinkle glitter and then they just kind of pat it off and clean it all off. And this, all we do is just braid that. And it's just like a little rubber band, a little hair tie deal. And you just kind of hair tie it on there. We have to get ourselves ready. We have to get our black pants. We're supposed to keep them clean, but I'm bad at that. And we got to get all this makeup on. And we have our hair bows to match our horses' hair bows. Yeah, we have our own horsetail. Mine's thick enough, too, to be a horsetail. Yeah, she doesn't like this one. This isn't hers. This is this one's. They all have their own grain because they all get different things in their grain. So they get different supplements in them. So she's not digging this one because hers doesn't have all this stuff in it. So I can't give him. She gets grain that has molasses in it, and because it makes him hyper stuff. He can't have it because when he gets molasses and he gets energy in his system, he tends to spaz out. Tomorrow, me and this one get to get up bright and early and go barrel racing three rivers, which I think we have a very good chance of doing good at. I'm very excited for it.
A little bit of problem negotiating the first barrel, but we're in good shape now. All right, we got two standing. Nice turn around the third one. Come on home, Siarra, right here. Three rivers, pair off. 22 and 30.
The scene behind me here is a bunch of young girls who are getting ready to compete in a rodeo. Now, thousands of young girls all across America love competing in these rodeos. They compete in everything from the big national rodeos to little tiny rodeos called jackpots. Well, we went to a jackpot in Sanger, California, and here's what happened.
Hey, come on, Roddy! No! 19, 1,
the scenes here at the rodeo as everybody's getting ready for the big performance. I can tell you that these girls and their horses are tremendous athletes. They're in top physical condition and they train hard both mentally and physically to get ready, as you'll see in this next video.
Both get down to both knees. Okay, now sit down on your heels. Good loop, good loop, good loop. So feet out. Push your arm that way. Spin. Around. Use your spin. All right, now when you start to go around the world, okay, you're here. Don't roll your shoulder forward. Okay, your shoulder comes up, push, it's your hips. Your hips come forward. You're here. Your arm's behind you. Down off of your hip. Arm back. See how I pull my arm back? Now go around. So when I'm telling that next horse to go, that'll be me doing what's called the full fender drag, where I'm like dragging fully from his, just by the stirrups. So we're getting that moment of thing, and then I'm just like dragging, and then Katie and another girl will be on the two other horses standing up with American flags. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, leg over. Toes forward, push forward, from the side. Okay, vault on. Don't lift, don't kick your heels to your butt.
I want you to be really careful, Juliana. When you're running beside, you tend to pull up on your arms and you pull your feet back like this. It's knees to chest, not heels to backside, okay?
Make it more flow. When you kick over, just shoot forward. Like your leg and stuff coming over is fine. You just gotta have more flow and be more comfortable.
She teaches character, a responsibility, there's chores, and then the self-discipline and the artisticness of it, I guess, if that's a word. There's so much. There's so many reasons.
That was really, looked really good.
This is beautiful Three Rivers, California, and it's home to the Riata Ranch, a legendary place where cowboys and cowgirls have been learning and studying trick riding for more than 40 years. People come from all over the world to learn the secrets, so let's take a look.
about the things we could be.
Hi, my name is Yanis, I'm from Spain. I'm here for tree grading.
Hello, my name is Antoine, this is Remington. I'm from France and I'm here to train.
Hi, my name is Katie Conley, I'm from Canada and I've been here for a couple months training. I'll be in the show.
Hi, my name is Fanny, I'm from France and I'm here to perform with Rethink Media.
Hello, I'm from France, I'm Theo and I'm there to train too.
But because the show starts in Quebec and the director is a Quebecois guy, so like in Quebec it's very popular and in Canada too, because Cavalier is famous in Canada.
I don't think the world is sold, I'm just doing what we're told. Kills me, makes me feel alive. I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be.
Since I'm 6, I have horses in my house in France. So my parents put me on a horse since I'm 6 years old. So yeah, I was always with horses. To be a team with a horse is very good. I like it because sometimes you don't really want to work and he has a lot of energy, so he can help you to go to work, do you understand? And sometimes the horse is tired and sore and don't want to go, and me, I really want to go ride and do, I don't know, some jumping or some trick ride.
Could lie. Everything that drowns me makes me feel alive. I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard, said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars.
Goodbye party for you.
Or a see you later party.
Yeah.
See you later party.
No, you guys can't leave.
In the last few minutes, you've seen a lot of exciting rodeo action and met some really interesting cowgirls. Well, let me tell you, listen to that. You ain't seen nothing yet, because we have so much more in store for you on Cowgirl Divas, and we'd like you to be a part of it.
Can I go?
Yes.